Good morning. It is anyways, it's Sunday and it has been 1 week since it has been 1 week since orientation has started, and I have completed 1 week of orientation. And so I'll just basically give you an overview of the first week. So the first week, basically Monday through about Saturday, we had things from about 8 to 5. Saturday started in the afternoon and ended like mid-evening, where it was like a field day. And like Monday was basically like HR stuff, like what to do for safety, what to do when you have someone who is basically trying to hurt you, like welcome to Piedmont, and basically like a lot of like human resources things. And then Tuesday, when I tell you the hammer came down, it was like boop, 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 boop. You know, like it was literally like that. Because, and the reason why I say that is they warn you, even, you know, Piedmont, they warned us and they were like, hey, Monday's gonna be chill, but Tuesday, you're gonna feel overwhelmed, I'm telling you now. And I was like, okay, yeah, you know, they always say, you know, some people, they tell you something, you're overwhelmed and then you're not. So I was like, let me just see for myself. And when I tell you on Tuesday, I was like, that tear was forming. It was forming, it did not drop. But it was forming, just because there was just so much information and like all these, you know, these exams that we have to take. And medicine just in general has a lot of exams. Like, you're never gonna ever finish taking exams for the rest of your career, whether it's every 10 years or you have in-service exams or you have board exams or you have step 3 that has to be done. And the one that was the most overwhelming for me was step 3, because in my mind I was like, okay, I have to take step, they had already told me on interview that I had to take step 3 by in December. So I was thinking that like I would take it in December and have the results by the very end of December or very early January. So I planned my vacation based off of that, so I can have basically just no other duties other than just making sure I have all my stuff together. But I did not know that it had to be resulted. And you know, with board exams, they take 4 to 6 weeks. So instead of my vacation being in December, it should have been in like October, November. So it was just like I already started like doing UWorld and stuff for step 3, but it was just kind of like, I had this idea in my head and plan. I'm like type A, I plan everything. I have like 4 million calendars. You see that calendar over there? Can I see that calendar? I have a calendar there. I have a calendar on my phone. I have a calendar that I write in. Like, I'm like 8 to 9. I'm doing this. 9 to 10. I'm doing this. And so when you're coming into something new, it's hard. I think it's hard for type A personalities because we're so, or what we call in Piedmont, the yellow team, in which they're very like, this is the rules, this is what we're going to do. And they're very strategic in their planning. They have a schedule and everything. So majority of medicine is like that, and it does, but sometimes you have to be able to adapt. So that part was like, okay, like that took me like a day to process everything that we have to do. And then I was like, okay, so I have that. And then I realized that I didn't have a necessarily issue. I won't have an issue necessarily with the amount of work or the amount of things I need to do for medicine. I started to feel slightly overwhelmed. I'm not even gonna say slightly. I was overwhelmed with how I'm gonna fit Sherry. Like, how is Sherry gonna fit in this? Sherry will do the best she can when it comes to residency. She would do the best she can as a physician, and I would do the best I can for my patients. But what about Sherry as a person? You know, what will she, how will she be taken care of in this process? And like I said before in previous videos, I did not understand how important self-care was until like third or fourth year of medical school, and I learned the hard way. But things are gonna be a lot different than medical school for residency. So trying to make sure that I'm taken care of in the process, is gonna be a little bit difficult, but I have to make time because I know how important that is. And I just don't know how I'm gonna do it yet because our schedules differ. You know, they're different based off what blocks you're on, you know, what attending you have. So I'm gonna just like do that as a work in progress every day. I wanna make sure that I'm also able to take care of myself because I think that in medicine, it is a selfless job. But however, if you don't take care of yourself, you won't be able to take care of other people. So getting back to working out, getting back to, I will always call my parents every day. Like that's without a question. Like I'm gonna call my family every day. But as far as like myself, like the things I like to do, like planting, skating, things that really help with my stress, like working out, listening to music, just sitting down for like an hour, just dancing in my room, which I just finished doing. to make sure that I'm okay. So that part I'm still figuring out. But yesterday, Saturday, was a lot of fun. We had a resident field day. And when I tell you, I had so much fun. I'll show you some clips and everything from the weekend resident field day. And next week, we have one more week of orientation. Then during that week, we'll be like OSCEs. And, you know, how refresh on exams. Grady became ACLS and BLS and PAL certified, which is basically CPR. We did that this past week. So we're doing other things to make sure that we're certified, have everything good for licensing, and still learning our way around and scheduling and things of that nature, and some shadowing before we start on July 1st. So I'll just insert some clips here and there so you can see like how it was during the 2 weeks of orientation. So hope you enjoy it. Bye.
Analyzing heart rhythm.
Okay, good.
Very good.
Do not touch the patient.
I don't know.
We have to be ready.
I'm ready. I'm gonna be ready.
Oh,
they got it. Yeah, we'll
put
the video for you.
Get ready.
Let's go.
Let's go. Wait, we're first. Hey. Go. Yeah, go. Ready? Yeah, that's good. Just keep going. Let's go. Yeah. Good. All right. Come on. You guys got it.
Wait.
You're good. Don't worry. All right, go. All right, you guys are good. Go. Ready? Go. Go. Yeah, there it is.
There we go. Pick it up.
Nice. Let's go. Oh, we're good. Let's go, Athena. Yes. Good job. Yeah. Let's go. You got it. Let's go. Yeah. Wait, we don't have to do it. All right, go. Yeah, let's go. All right, no, you guys go.
You got it.
Come on, you got it. Yeah, there you go.
Let's go, Walter. Let's go. Yes.